Welcome back to another video, and this week we are comparing Vietnamese and Filipino food. We've been to Filipino restaurants like 3 times now,
so they were all really good.
Really good, but we thought it's time we give somewhere else a chance. So we're going to compare the two because they're both from Southeast Asia, and we're going to see what comes out on top.
So we're in our local town, and I don't know if you can see that little bridge.
Let me zoom in.
On the other side of that bridge is a private island.
It is really nice. I don't think you appreciate where you live enough. It's not shut, is it? Check it.
Don't.
Sunday's closed.
You'd
Brilliant.
Think on a Sunday food places would be open.
Wouldn't you? You think it's meant... Right, well, we're lucky because we do have two Vietnamese...
Very strange. In our very small local town, we have two Vietnamese restaurants.
And I think that's got to be like sort of the first point that Vietnamese food in London is a lot more accessible than Filipino. So yeah, faux Saigon, we are not impressed. Closed on a Sunday. That's got to be the best day to be getting food, isn't it?
I'm now searching because we have one called Naha Trang Kitchen.
Naha Trang Kitchen,
and they are
please,
open,
please be open.
Midday to 9 p.m. every day. It's now 10 to 2, so.
Well, it's not. That is two. You've got to be kidding.
So the only two places that do Vietnamese food in our area, and they're both shut on a Sunday when people want to go out and eat.
Okay, so it's Google Maps time and looking for the next closest Vietnamese restaurant because we've got to get this done today, I'm afraid.
We have to.
This is an absolute disaster. How can both of them be shut? Molly's looking in the next closest town, which is like 5 minutes down the road.
No worries, I found one.
One that's open. Well, is it open though?
Yeah, it's definitely open. Well, you know, I don't trust this. It
Fingers
says
crossed.
It's open 11:30, so we better go and give it a try. It's called Pho. Pho.
Pho Pho.
It's called, no, it's just called Pho.
Please be open.
So, third time lucky, we are going to...
That's it, up there
Pho.
Somewhere. Pho,
so
that's right.
It is. It's a Vietnamese restaurant, and we've been looking for so long, so I'm really hungry, really excited. It's very sour. I mean, in comparison to Filipino food, it does say that it's not so sweet, but we're not going to try the national Vietnamese dish of pho, because we're going to save that for when we go to Vietnam.
Whoa.
What?
Have you just stop the music. Have you just told them somewhere else that we're going?
Was I not meant to say?
We were only meant to be telling the Philippines, Vietnam. Right, I'm going in. So I've just got into Pho. And first impressions of the menu is huge. There's so many different options compared to the Filipino restaurants. But compared to the other two Vietnamese that we looked at, this has got a lot more options. The other two are very basic. So, what are you thinking?
Well, I'm thinking, as soon as we love rice, we love pork. Why don't we go for the broken rice with charred pork? It sounds a bit like
sissy. That was what I was thinking, and it's a good comparison.
It is a good comparison.
So I think try that, and
obviously we've got to get
Saigon. We've got to try the Saigon beer. I don't think it's
going
to compare it to Red Horse. I don't see it being as strong, so I might be able to have two or three of this.
Can we get two Saigon?
Definitely.
And then to share, can we get the broken rice with the charred pork?
Please.
There's no way I'm going to be able to use them.
I'll
can you use them?
How on earth can you separate them?
Can you use chopsticks?
No.
No, nor, see, we're going to have to learn before we go away.
No.
You've got to learn, because that is...
I want to eat with a spoon and a fork.
Yeah, the Filipino way.
We'll try, we've got to try.
I'll try. It's going to be quite embarrassing, but
it'll
enjoy, guys.
Hours,
okay. So, our Saigon beer has come. What percentage is this one? What percent is it?
4.9.
Ah, you could have a few of them.
What was Red Horse?
6 point something.
This has got like a really, I don't know how to describe it, it's like fruity.
It's a bit fruity.
Which makes it really nice, which makes it slide down, but you'd have to drink a lot of them to get to where you'd want to be.
What do you think taste wise? Red Horse or Saigon?
I definitely think the Red Horse is more refreshing. This is, although it goes down very
It's a bit too fruity, is that what you said? Yeah, I'm going to have to
I
give this a go.
It could be a little bit too thick.
If you want a beer, you want beer taste.
Exactly.
Yeah. I like it, but it is a little bit like, a little bit bitter, it's got that fruity taste, sometimes a little bit too much, so I'm definitely going to Red Horse, because I might prefer that lager taste.
Yeah.
And Red Horse has got that strong lager taste, and it's cheaper than that Red Horse. I'm going to need 3 Red Horse, I'm going to need 5 or 6 of them to have a good night. So Red Horse it is 1-0.
I think I got it wrong. I think I said it's 1-0 Philippines, but I think it's going to have to be 1-0 because accessibility.
Accessibility-wise,
Vietnamese is a lot more accessible. Like, we've found 4 or 5 within a 20-minute radius of us, whereas Filipinos, we're looking at a 45-minute drive into central London, which is a shame because we loved it so much.
Wow, look at that. That does look lovely, doesn't it? And
it's
the pork. The pork isn't sizzling like sisig, but it does look like it's got the skin on it, the outer skin, so it might be a little bit similar.
And they have got like peanuts, so I feel like it could taste similar.
But like they said, Vietnamese put so many vegetables in there, like vegetable overload.
Molly's attempting it with the chopsticks. Right. So you've got to get a little bit of this, a little bit of that.
Do you know what? This is so hard.
We've got to learn. Go on.
That's nice. It's not as tender as a sisig.
No.
Honestly. The rice is nice as well, but...
Is it a little bit chewy?
Yeah, it's a bit chewy.
I like how sucky. Yeah? We prefer sticky rice.
But it's got a nice flavour, but I do prefer the sticky rice. It's definitely not as sweet. It's a bit sour. You better have a go. Right, so pinch them together.
I don't know how you do this. Pinch them together.
Cross them over, yeah. All right, now that's it. Then use your fingers.
This is very, like, disrespectful.
It's like teaching a child. Go on, that's it.
Bit of rice.
Yeah.
Well, hey. No more. Very nice.
Do you get what I mean about it being a bit more sour?
It's a little bit more sour. I think that's what the vegetables are in.
Yeah.
And comparing it back to the sisig, which we think is the closest similar thing, the pork here in the Vietnamese box is a little bit too chewy.
Yeah.
The sisig can get that lovely crunch on the skin, whereas this, it's just like this half the whole way through and I'm chewing it. And I don't like that, it just becomes like a chore having to chew it the whole way through. My mouth ends up hurting by the end of it, so I'm sort of edging towards the bottom. I'm not edging, I'm all the way for the sisig at the moment, but I haven't finished the bowl.
You've got radish, cucumber. I don't know what this is, I think this might be lettuce.
Yeah, big bit of lettuce.
And then I'm going to dare you to have this big chili. Look how big it is.
I'll have it in a minute. Don't you worry. I've got that beer to wash it down with. But yeah, what do you think? It's not quite sisig, is it? And again, it's not sizzling. And I love the spice of the sisig. You've got a couple of jalapenos in there, but it's not actually spicy.
It's like peanutty taste or sweet taste. It's all very plain. He's going for the big chili.
He's going for it.
He's going for the big guns. Go on.
Oh, actually, hold on. That is spicy.
You're going a bit red. Is it a bit hot?
Very red. That's very, very hot.
Pulling out that hot stuff. I need to add that sizzle to it.
Don't put it anywhere near mine.
Why is it not coming out?
Oh, because somebody didn't unscrew the cap.
Go on, put a little bit on my bit.
How's that?
What? My mouth. Do you want to bump? How
yes.
much is that?
A
I'm
lot.
Gonna be in trouble.
I'll spoon
this.
It for you.
Okay. Zoom in on that.
I don't know if you can see
how
it.
Much,
you can't see. Oh, yeah,
is
you
that
can.
What sauce have you put in there?
Yeah. Right.
I think another point that you've got to take into account when comparing the two is price. And of course we're talking about this in London, not in the Philippines and Vietnam, so we know it'd be a lot cheaper. The Filipino restaurants have come across a lot cheaper. That might be because they're more family run, and obviously Jollibee's a fast food chain, so it would be cheaper. This Vietnamese one in London, we're only talking London, remember that, has been nearly double the price. The variety in the Vietnamese restaurants was great, much like the Filipino. But then desserts wise, there's no desserts menu. Not if you've had your dinner, you want something sweet. And we wanted to be able to compare it to Hello Hello, which we loved. And there's nothing here to compare it to. So I think, again, it's got to be another point to the Philippines.
I also just want to say about portion size, I do feel that the love to feed you up. This was quite a small portion. It was obviously only got one to share, but I think the Filipino portions are much bigger, which we prefer.
Yeah,
so
I agree.
What's that,
3-0? 4-0? 4-1. Accessibility. Vietnamese has got the accessibility.
4-1.
And it doesn't fill you, because a lot of it's veg with this, so it doesn't fill you up as much.
No.
With a big bit of rice and a big bit of meat, it hits the spot.
So it comes with the bill. The bill comes with this really cool postcard. I don't know if you can see that little logo there. It's the logo of the restaurant. It's so cute.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Oh, how do you feel?
I feel content, it was good.
I'm not stuffed though, are you?
I'm not stuffed. It doesn't feel, there's too many vegetables, so it doesn't really fill you up that much.
No, I agree.
I don't know what it ended up. I'm going to say 5-1, 6-1.
We've lost count.
The benefit of the Vietnamese food was the accessibility. We did like it, I loved it. And because Molly's giving it away, when we go to Vietnam, we will love the Vietnamese food.
Of course we will.
Because it's going to be a little more to try.
If anyone is in the London area, Pho in Kingston was lovely. The variety of main meals is unbelievable, and we probably would have tried something else if we weren't comparing it to the Filipino dishes.
There was a lot more on there that I think we could have eaten.
Comparing that specific dish
to
the sisig, and comparing the price and stuff like that, we definitely go for the Filipino. We prefer the Filipino dishes, just because there's more meat as well.
They're also sweeter, which I think is more to our palate.
That's
so.
It, a lot more sweeter. And that definitely gets the thumbs up from us. But guys, if you're new to the channel, make sure you subscribe, like, and leave a comment letting us know what's your favourite Southeast Asian cuisine. And be sure to subscribe, because 4 weeks from now, big announcement, we will be starting daily travel vlogs from the beginning of March.
So
guys, I'll repeat again, like, subscribe,
and keep on dabbling.